You try to engage the keys on some sort of twisted Escher-esque impossibility wherein they unlock each other in an infinite loop, but it fails. Okay. What else? We got this. This is Sir Bappy Pawswater, your beloved Manthro chap. You tend to his fussy whims and needs when you trouble to imagine what they might be. What a daring dream to combine the finest qualities of the animal kingdom with the nobility of humanimals. Wait, you mean humanity. Anyway, Sir Bappy Pawswater will have to tend to his own fussy whims and needs for a while. You've got a lot of crap on your plate right now. Sir Pawswater... Pawswater... I think... Is that spelled wrong? Keeps his own counsel. His secrets are his own affair, and he cares little for yours. He can be kind of a snide little puffed-up popinjay when you get right down to it. Yeah, it is Pawswater. They spelled it wrong there. I thought it was. Sir Bappy Pawswater is underwhelmed by your beloved keepsake. Well, whatever. He's never been an easy fellow to impress. He practices composure for hours every night in front of his placidity glass, sold separately. It's just not in the spirit of the quasi-Victorian barnyard aesthetic of the Manthro chaps. Also, the walkie needs batteries. Sir Bappy Pawswater, spelled wrong again, disdains tap dancing, which he calls the staccato stumbling of the plebeian herd. And wow, that stings. We're walking... Oh, this is a separate room. Okay, got it. I guess we've looked at everything in this room. I try to be, like, really thorough. What if I try to tap dance on the computer? We try that. Okay, so we go into this other room. And I looked at maybe one thing in here. We can't look at the... The windows? No, they're part of the... So what have we got in here? Oh. Oh my god, what's that? Looks like Jude scurried up to his treehouse to get away from that thing, unsurprisingly. He acts like it's his mission control room up there, as if a goofy kid legitimately has any secret business of that sort. Outrageous. You're not allowed up there, he says. To which you reply, you'd rather step on a rake than set foot in his rickety little nerd hut. You school him so often, you really should be pulling in a teacher's salary. What the hell are these? Yikes, more of them? Gentrification is a real monster. Blistering social commentary aside, you secretly hope you and your brother aren't killed and eaten by these eyeless horrors. I'm loving this game so far. Remember when you were raking up those leaves? Your dog knocked Jude over, and you laughed, and then everything turned to monstrous. Ah, memories. That was about a half hour ago. Treehouse. You briefly muse on the metaphorical significance of the flashing light. What could it represent? The past? The future? America? It was probably Jude flashing that as some kind of Morse code. It's your stupid brother. You need to get in touch with him. These? And the moon? Or maybe? The sun has just set, making for a glorious autumn eve. As such, autumnal evening glory radiates from the heavens, kissing the clouds on its way down to Earth. Stupid clouds, all untouchable and ephemeral and stuff. So I can't click on these, specifically? I guess not. What's this? It'd be nice if those monsters were as weirded out by that weird skull fountain as you are. Unfortunately, that thing is probably monster chic. Poor puppy. If that icky, sneaky thing hurt her, well, you'd use your budding veterinary skills to patch her up and make it all better, but you'd also be very angry. Right now, she doesn't seem to want to come out of her doghouse. You don't blame her. Okay, so some things we don't recognize. This is supposed to be here. This is supposed to be here. These are not supposed to be here. That's new. I'm guessing these are new. The doghouse is supposed to be there. I don't know about this thing. We can't look at that, apparently. You eye the bushes suspiciously, but don't see anything else popping out of them yet. Nothing else to look at. Trail. I mean, steps. Stuff like that. Alright. There's stuff here. Okay, look at that. Beanbags are making a big comeback lately. It beats sitting on the floor, and that's all you can really ask of a beanbag. Okay, we looked at him in the other room, so... You know that windows aren't locked with actual keys, generally. They just have a little mechanism on top that prevents someone from pushing them open from the outside. But you jab the key at the window anyway, because you play by your own rules. Yep, that's how we roll. Your precious heirloom? That your precious mother left your... her precious daughter? You? Just throw that out the precious window? No way! Whoa, it just needs some batteries. No need to smash the window open and just scream your talkies out in the pitiless night. Yeah. The sill is a little too narrow for you to dance on it. Otherwise, you'd do it in a heartbeat, obviously. It's kind of a miracle that this thing hasn't split open already like Jude's did. You don't think shoving a key into it is a very polite way to say thanks. Your mother left you this beautiful key, and you've always treasured it. Similarly, sort of, your pa left a bunch of 20-year-old beanbag chairs in the attic, and your babysitter distributed them throughout the house for fun. It was fun, but you guessed it. It's not all that similar to the precious, beautiful heirloom, really. You root around in the beanbag. There were no batteries in the beanbag. You were blown away. Sometimes you like to sit there and relax after a hard afternoon's practice. It's easier to relax when you're kind of worn out. Otherwise, your brain is going a mile a minute, and you have to distract yourself with puzzles or check your sights or something like that before you start thinking about stuff that makes you sad. Did I do this? Oh, yeah, I did. Alright, anything here? Nintendos and stuff? The bounty hunter's advice for dealing with monsters would probably be to shoot them, or change your shape, or both at once. She's cool, but pretty difficult to emulate. Star Adventures, Ginger Rogers? Ginger Rogers? Gosh, she's really something. The greatest tap dancer who ever clattered gracefully across the screen. Probably? No, wait. Definitely. And still kicking. What could possibly go wrong? That's what Bubsy would say, if he were here. He'd never stop saying it. You'd hear it in your head forever, echoing like screams echo across still water. You love Block Hustle, the game of descending columns that disappear as lines are filled, but you could only find a poster of the American box art. Second Mom? This game is only available in Japan, but there's this kid at school who says his uncle works at a games company, and he gets to play all sorts of secret games before they even come out here. He runs off at the mouth like he has all this insider information and sources inside the game companies, but honestly, you think he's just desperate for attention. Yeah, probably. You tend to ignore him and focus on more pleasant things, like this super cool poster. Second Mom rules. Hot steppin'? Like Flashdance? Kinda looks like. Hot steppin'. You don't really perform the styles of dance that make this movie such a pulse-pounding barn burner of a smash hit, but you'd certainly like to, someday. The story keeps happening. Just look at that childlike empress. She sure looks pretty pleased with herself as someone who's only been in the movie for about 5 minutes. Canadian Campfire Spookums is the best. It's about these kids who get together in the woods every week, and one of them throws some dust in a fire, and they tell a scary story, and that scary story is the episode. Acorn Shadow. You guess you kind of focus more on the framing narrative than you did on the stories, but whatever. It's the best, just like you said. Acorn's shadow is surprisingly dark for a show about a group of horse friends. It canters down some troubling psychological roads. Magical Animal Companion Heal Rescue is your favorite Japanimation. Oh my god, they call it Japanimation? That's right. It's about this girl, Shika, who goes to school sometimes and has a regular life. Boring, yeah. But whenever a magical animal has been hurt, Shika becomes Princess Shika and rides her dear companion to go heal them. I swear I haven't heard the word Japan or read the word Japanimation in at least over 5 years. But hey, this is the 90s. That's the whole thing. It's great. No fighting, just healing. You love it. Oh, the diary. I'm gonna get to that last, probably. Oh, look at this. Since she's been gone, you've been less and less of Pa over the years. Guess he had greener pastures to move onto, or bluer beauties. That little girl there, she's destined for big things. Big hopes, big fears, big worries, big lonelinesses. Aw. Now hold on, pull yourself together. What would your mom say if she knew you were thinking like that? You really wish you knew. You should write more about how you feel about your mom and your mom being gone and all that stuff, but it's not easy. Your secrets are safe with you. Your precious treasured heirloom belonged to your mom, originally. You got it from her jewelry box, the one in the hallway. She wasn't around to give it to you in person, so you just, you know, you took it, but that's what she would have wanted, of course. You're very, very sure of it. This picture was taken before you found your treasured heirloom, you think. Sometimes it can be hard to remember the exact sequence of things like that. It's weird being 14. Over a third of your life is, at very best, a blurry fog in your memory. Throw in the time you spend asleep and, well, you've really only got about 6 years of accessible, conscious memory. Weird. I never quite thought of it like that. You really wish you could. If you want to talk to yourself, your diary is right there. Your mom was a great dancer. Tap, swing, ballroom, bolero, even wild experimental stuff like contact improvisation. Ballet was her passion, though, and she was transcendent. Tap dancing actually freaks your dog out pretty badly. You suppose it's the ribald, firework-like percussion of your toes and heels clacking against the hardwood floor that does it. In fact, you don't really have to suppose, you're pretty much certain. Or rather, certain. I got all this crap. Oh no, your hop-stepping thoughts go in the other diary, the one you will never mention again outside of this particular thought. Yep, I'm gonna do it all. This kid could care less about your diary, he's too busy reading The Story Keeps Happening. Wait. Was the name of the movie also the name of the actual book the kid was reading? You can't remember right now. I'm just going to finish hot-stepping. Your mom, would she be okay with this poster being up in your room? Eh, why not? She danced with lots of ladies. If only the walkie-talkie were powered by the raw, rhythmic sensuality, then, well, you guess you feel pretty strange using it to talk to your brother. No, that's not tap dance. Tap dance is great and fun, but it's like doing your taxes at church compared to what's going on that poster. I did that. Oh. Huh. Actually, yeah, your heirloom kind of reminds you of that weird snaky amulet thing from this movie. It's way older than this movie, though, by at least several years, as you can personally verify. Walkie-talkies, even currently inoperable ones, are more sci-fi conspiracy, whereas this movie was more high fantasy. Mixing them up could get a little messy. You had a routine inspired by this movie, but it was just way too long. You guess you could say it felt always non-stopping. Ooh, one campfire spookum was about a haunted diary. When you wrote in it, it would write back, and it turned out that, well, you guess you already mentioned that it was haunted. So yeah, a ghost. Kinda reminds me of, Harry Potter and the second one. He's taking a drink while I think of that. Harry Potter and the, not the Sorcerer's Stone, or Philosopher's Stone, rather. God, the second movie. I just have to write it down. Harry Potter. It's killing me. But yeah, Tom Riddle. Voldemort. Sorry, spoiler. Ginny would, I think it was Ginny would write in the diary, and he'd write back or something like that. So that was a diary, that's that. Your mom's heirloom? No. It wouldn't make a very good spookum. It's just not scary. And it's just very pretty, and holding it makes you feel very happy and very sad at the same time. If this were a Canadian campfire spookum, the walkie would probably start working without batteries, and then it'd be the ghost of some kid from 50 years ago, or even an alien. That'd be pretty fun, until the realities of the situation set in. What if you just couldn't stop dancing? That'd be scary, if it didn't describe your life already. Joey Clare extraordinaire. How can you keep a secret safe from your own shadow? This question is explored over 17 seasons of Acorn Shadow, and is usually a source of conflict in any given episode. Wow. That's a lot of seasons. The only one I can think is longer than maybe MASH, which is 20 seasons, I think? Acorn is always finding mysterious treasures, but unlike you, she usually finds out what they are within 22 minutes. You've been waiting for years. Acorn really doesn't need a walkie to talk to her shadow, especially when it's lurking all huge and malevolent like that, like he always does in every episode. Oh, I forgot. Hold on. Dance for Acorn. Clopping their hoof is how horses count, except the titular Acorn Shadow, of course. It's too busy burning the land with galloping green flames to do horsey math tricks. You can't really picture the bounty hunter keeping a diary. A war journal, maybe. Ugh, Jude's rubbing off on you. The bounty hunter is from the distant future. She has no need for pretty relics of your family history. Or maybe she's from the distant past, in a part of space where the technology is comparatively futuristic. That'd be pretty wild. Point stands about your key, though. You give it a shot. No luck. Or, the bounty hunter is one of those no-talk heroes. She might be responding, silently. You decide to pretend she's responding, silently. The bounty hunter would be pretty excellent in any style that featured a turn a ball into mid-air maneuver. And what style wouldn't benefit from such a maneuver? Why, none of them. Star Avenue. You've read Ginger's memoir, Ginger, My Story, a couple of times. It's great. She's really funny, and wow, women sure have had to put up with a lot of crap, huh? You're class of the 90s now, so that kind of thing should be over pretty soon. Yeah, we're kind of still working on it. It's getting there. Your mom and Ginger actually knew each other. They were of different generations, of course, but super classy entertainers like them can't help but run into each other all the time. Now, not literally, of course. They would have been... Both would have been way too graceful for that. Walking? Talking? Who cares about that jazz when there's dancing to do? Hee hee. You got kind of caught up in your Ginger Rogers bit that it's fun. And that's fun, but maybe keep in mind that you really need to get in touch with your brother. Yeah, if he's not doomed by now, I think he'll be fine. Oh, I messed that up. Hold on a second. Your tap dancing idol, of course, after your mom. But Ginger's a close second. She's just amazing. Block Hustle has no secrets that they aren't willing to share with you. They keep their own counsel. A brightly colored L-shaped object. No, it couldn't be. It's not. You're just goofing around. No response from Detective Block Hustle. Private Eye. Maybe something is blocking the signal. Oh, the music in Block Hustle is perfect for tap dancing, but you have to play the game in order to hear it, and that's distracting. You tried having Jude play while you worked out a routine, but he refused to play ever since he found out the game is Russian. Cold War is over, buddy, even in the 90s. Your diary provides no insight into why you hung up this poster. You've reread it many times, searching for just that information. The contrast between your most treasured possession and your least treasured possession is pretty striking, by which you mean playing a Bubsy game is like being struck. No thanks. He can stay quiet for once. No one can dance to the Bubsy theme, not even Bubsy. He just thrashes around like a jerk and then smirks at you, like he just totally blew your mind. Sometimes you hate living in the 90s. Now, yeah, there's another thing here. Oh, I didn't do this? Oh, I did that. Second Mom. Lots of games help you have you save by writing in a diary, but in Second Mom you literally save by calling your dad. What a whimsical idea. Imagine, a father whose phone number you know, who picks up when you call. Oh, that's sad. You bet the hero of Second Mom has some kind of cool heirloom, too, like a yo-yo carved from some crazy mineral or something. Awesome. You're not a big minerals person, but that's awesome. You wish you could radio the hero of Second Mom for help. Look how cool she is. All you have is your stupid brother. Treasure him. He's the only one you have left. This game apparently has really cool music. By searching online, you were able to briefly hear a few seconds of it. The download only took you a few hours. Wow. Living in the future sure is amazing. No, that, I can verify that. That's true. I remember in 98? I believe it was 98. I downloaded a video of EverQuest, like alpha footage or something like that. It was like a trailer. The thing played in like a 320 by 320 window, I believe it was. And yeah, it took me about like 5 hours to download that thing on dial-up. And it was like, I don't know, like less than 20 megs. So yeah, so you guys have it made right now. Compared to us. Alright, let's look at these game consoles. A prodigious collection of titles for your console's hungry cartridge-shaped mouth. All the best ones are here. Well, all the ones you happen to own are here. You can spend all day listening to them. There's Bubsy, there's... Mentioning Bubsy made you feel a little queasy, so you think you'll stop there. You might go lie down for a bit, actually. You love your video game console. You're a computer games enthusiast at heart, but you can't help but enjoy the tactile sensation of a controller in your hand as you fight evil and save animals and etc. Lots of etc. Okay, so these are two consoles. Alright. So I can also play, but first... You think back to when you were little and you used to stick the end of the controller cord in your pocket and pretend you were controlling yourself. Courageous Joey, off on an exciting adventure, fighting monsters, solving puzzles. You don't need the controller anymore, but you wouldn't mind having a little bit of that old courage back. Yeah, I control her now. This heirloom thingamajig has sometimes made you feel like, well, like you might be someone special. Like, you might have an adventure one day or something, like someone cool from one of your games. It's just got the feeling to it, you know? You guess all kids probably feel this way sometimes. And maybe there's something too special about you. Maybe there's nothing too special about you, sorry. But then again, monsters? Okay, so maybe there will be something special about your death. Nice. No, only the original Japanese control had the microphone... Japanese console had a microphone controller. Or at least that's what you read about on the internet while you were looking for info about Second Mom. Don't break the systems. It tends to make your game freeze. Also, the only downside of cartridge-based gaming. So what about these things? This is separate, right? You jab your diary key at the console, whimsically hoping this combo might save the game of your very life, but it doesn't. It just scratches the plastic a bit. Okay. So I try this. You dare? You dare to call upon the raw and ancient magics of the game genie? Have you lost your mind? Okay, enough fooling around. You don't really have one of those whimsically named cheat devices, but sometimes you like to pretend you do, and that it's actually a big scary genie who is all mad about his circumstances. No way are you scavenging your console games for batteries to power your walkie-talkie. They need those to preserve your precious saves. It's very important to be able to save. You love it. Interesting how... I'm noticing how, you know, walkie-talkie, of course, is in caps because, well, it's a thing in the game, but save is a thing in the game. Love, very important, is a thing in the game. One more. And send them clatterin'? No way. Connect four. The goal of this game is to get four of your colored circles in a row before your opponent, who's trying to do the same. You can also theoretically connect five if you're a kind of showy jerk. So I can't play that. I am going to play the thing in a little bit. This just goes there. Okay. Thought I might be able to open a drawer or something. What about this? Oh. Oh, that's part of the... I thought there was a figurine that's part of that poster. Never mind. And that, obviously, is that. Connect 4 would make a lousy diary. One wrong move and bam, your secret ideas go tumbling all over the place. Pretty. Sweet key, this. Jude is terrible at this game. He always assumes you're trying to lure him into traps, so he makes strategically terrible moves to expose your conspiracy, and then you win. They don't need your help to fall. You just pull a tab on the side. So, okay, they need your help, but not your dancing. Alright, can we play this? You just save before fighting the final boss. Again, it's in caps. Which means you'll need to budget several hours to fight through its various forms and anti-forms and transformations. And look, you've got a lot on your plate right now. Oh, I was hoping it would be some kind of minigame. Alright, so that's it. And look up here, alright. Oh my god, all those Rubik's Cubes? Seriously? You really like this poster, but can't really say why. It's pretty, and you like the expression on the ballerina's face. You wonder if this is what it's like when adults go to museums to look at actual art. You hope so. Oh my god, Simon. I hope we don't have to play that. You give it a good, hard stare. Yeah, you're appreciating the heck out of this art. It would be difficult, if not impossible, for anyone to appreciate it more. You had a lot of complex and complicated feelings about this poster. Aspirations, admirations, aesthetic appreciations. Wanting to write all those down is why you got a diary, actually. But when you sat down to do it, you were kind of embarrassed by your flowery ideas. Maybe one day. Two of your most treasured possessions, like the ballerina, your heirloom, though still seems destined to turn. You're not sure where that idea came from. You always get like this when you look at your ballet poster for a while. She has no need of it. Like you, she communicates solely through the language of dance, and right now she's telling you to find some batteries for this thing. Maybe check in this closet. That's obviously the wrong school of dance for this poster. You need to put your suitable shoes on for this, by which you mean to dance in front of a poster. I don't know if there's other stuff I can find. So I can't look at these. You really get a charge out of this game. It's kind of bossy, though. Dear Diary, today I let a little game push me around and berated myself for not following its instructions accurately enough. Huff, pretty dark. Maybe work through those thoughts in your actual diary sometime. The game, the key, they both hold their sinister sway, don't they? Wait, what? What were you thinking just now? No idea. Right, that's where you put the walkie-talkie batteries. Better grab them. Jude needs your help. Okay, I'll do that in a second. Oh no, but what if it fell off the shelf and broke? Honestly, it'll be the excuse you've been needing to throw it out. It's kind of a rude game. Another time. Oh, right, that's where you put the walkie-talkie batteries. You'll just take them back out. Okay, one more game for old time's sake first. Jude's probably fine. Oh, here we go. I pressed it. Oh, looks like the green button isn't working. Well, nostalgia satisfied. Might as well scavenge the batteries. Huh? I hope it's not malfunctioning because the batteries are low. Now I got batteries.